Time 7:12 now. The kids head back to school this week for most districts. It can be a stressful time for both them and parents. So what can parents do to help calm the jitters and address concerns like bullying? A psychiatrist joins us next with some very helpful advice. Heading back to school brings about all kinds of emotions. Dr. Daniela White is a board-certified psychiatrist. She is the founder of the Midtown Psychiatry Center, and she's here with us this morning with advice for issues that parents will face, including bullying and how to handle social media as well. Good morning, Dr.
Good morning.
White.
Good morning.
So I want to talk to you first about the first day, because that can bring about a lot of nerves and jitters for the kids. What's your advice to parents to help them calm their fears?
Like you just said earlier, talk and communicate with them and listen to them and their emotions, and then normalizing them, letting them that most kids will feel the same, and you also as a kid felt the same way. And even as adults, we're still anxious when we start a new job, when we go from one place to work to another. Mm-hmm. So normalize their experiences and allow them to ask questions.
Getting them into a routine can probably help too, right?
Well, a week before school, yes, you have to restart the breakfast setups and the alarms to set up in the morning, and back to bedtime's routine and starting the school supply, trying to help them organize so the first day is not so overwhelming. Mm-hmm. And sometimes just talk to them what to expect, the layout of the school, where will they put the lockers. So we recommend parents to visit the school with them, and the schools also have opportunities about doing those open houses.
Right, telling them what to expect and having that reassurance can go a long way. Let's move on to another topic, and this is probably the most difficult one that any parent will face during the school year, and that's bullying.
Right.
If their child is being bullied, what are some signs that parents can look out for?
What a parent should look out is any change in patterns, in patterns of eating, in patterns of using the restroom, patterns of sleeping, sometimes refusal to go to school, changes in personality. Sometimes they become more moody or isolated, and then ask what happened at school. And then if the bullying does happen, then the parent have to make an effort to be more involved and involve all resources, mm-hmm. Counselor, principal, therapist, and ask the child, what do you think you should do? And then if the child doesn't have an answer, then you have to advise them not to bully back and to stand up to the bully. Being assertive can go a long way. I mean, what you ask them is to really look at the bully and say, you know, leave me alone, and then walk away and talk to an adult.
Mm-hmm. And then finally, I want to bring up the world of social media. What kinds of rules should parents be setting for their kids? And it really probably depends on the age, but what's some general things you can tell parents about rules for social media?
You have to have this contract set at the beginning. Most 13 years old already have a profile, and it's better to, as a parent, to know when that profile is set up so you can teach them the rules and the etiquette of the social media. And one very important point is privacy. So teach them not to reveal informations like phone numbers, addresses, email, social security, credit mm-hmm. cards. Set the privacy, and you know, be a friend on their list of friends.
Absolutely.
Be involved, and once you set up the account with them a little bit earlier, like 12 or 13, and that's the average age where kids want to become involved in social media, just be involved as mm-hmm. well.
And maybe say you can only use those social media platforms on a shared computer. You can't
share
use them on your phone, right?
On the living room. And
well, Dr. Daniela White, thank you so much for coming in. We sure do appreciate great advice this morning.